little old rundown shack, and in it lived a man I'd never seen. Folks said he was a mean and a vicious man, and you better not set foot on his land, but I didn't think nobody could be that mean. So I took me out walking down the railroad track. I was gonna go down to that little old shack and just find out if all them things I'd heard was true. There was a big black dog laying out in the yard, and it growled at me, and I swallowed hard, and I heard somebody say, "Well, who are you?" Oh, and there he stood in the door of that shack, and his beard and his hair was long and black, and he was the biggest man I'd ever seen. When he spoke, his voice was low and deep, but he just didn't frighten me, 'cause somehow I just knew he wasn't mean. He said, "What you doing snooping around my place?" And I saw a smile come across his face, so I smiled back and I told him who I was. He said, "Come on in and pull you up a chair. You might as well since you're already here." And he said, "You can call me Joshua. Joshua, Joshua, what you doing living here all alone? Joshua, Joshua, ain't you got nobody to call your own? No, 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 no." We talked till the sun was clean out of sight, and we still talking when it come daylight. There was just so much we had to say. Orphan's home, and just like him, I was all alone. So I said, "Yeah," when he asked if I'd stay. Oh, we grew closer as time went on, and that little old shack, it was a happy home, and we just couldn't help but fall in love. That big black dog in that little old shack, sitting down by the railroad track, it's plenty good enough for me and Joshua. Joshua, Joshua, why, you're just what I've been looking for. Joshua,